Intelligence which matters. The attempt to define intelligence in a more meaningful way. In a truly intelligent world, it would be good for yourself, for all fellow humans, and for all of nature and all sentient beings. True intelligence therefore sets itself this goal and tries to reach this state, this ideal, through purposeful action. True intelligence is therefore found in actions that increase one's own well-being, the well-being of all fellow humans, and the well-being of all sentient beings. This is my definition of true intelligence, and I would like to explain in this blog why I find this definition useful, at least more useful than those definitions of intelligence I have heard so far. I don't mean that I personally deserve the title intelligent. In general, I do not believe that we will find a person who can be described as completely intelligent at all, because in every single action that a human being performs, I think it should be weighted up anew whether this action was intelligent, that is, whether it was good towards itself, towards its fellow humans, and good towards nature, and I cannot imagine anyone who is always able to act intelligently. Often, for example, there are conflicts of interests or unknown feedback on our actions, but I believe that we would have a fairer world with happier people if more people saw intelligence in the sense of this definition, and if this concept were also thought in school in this understanding, which I believe is rather less the case. I suspect that at the moment most people would classify a professor of mathematics as more intelligent than a factory worker, for example, or a chess player more intelligent than a football player, or a lawyer more intelligent than a farmer, and so on. Perhaps this viewpoint applies to you as well. Or how do you define intelligence? When can a person call himself intelligent in your eyes? I think this is a very important question, because if you don't have a meaningful definition of intelligence, then you probably don't have a meaningful definition of stupidity. And I think it's very central to all of our lives who or what we call intelligent or stupid. Very common in this widespread idea of intelligence are so-called intelligence tests to make the intelligence of a person visible or quantify, and maybe you have ever wondered how high your IQ is. What do you suppose? 80, 100, 120? Or ask in another way, are you below average, average or above average intelligent? Do you even want to know, or are you a little scared of this test too? What would it mean to you if 80 came out? I don't think that there is a single person in this world who would not like to call himself intelligent. But I believe that there are many people in this world who feel that they are not intelligent people, that there are others who have been chosen. For example, those who excel in mathematics, or those who have studied, or those who are allowed to adorn themselves with a DR in front of their name, and so on. This idea is, in my opinion, deeply sad and then also completely nonsensical. I am convinced that the understanding of intelligence, which I feel we use in large parts of my culture, namely as a collective term for a specific group of cognitive performance characteristics, does more harm than good. Such a view leads to the fact that there are people who develop intelligence tests and assign a number to people, claiming that this number expresses how intelligent they are, although they cannot give a meaningful definition of intelligence, in my opinion. This view leads to a multi-class society and thus to a division into more valuable and less valuable people. Such a test under this name, intelligence, is unnecessary in my opinion, because it devalues people who score worse than others in such a test and then makes them feel for the rest of their lives that they are worth less than someone who scored higher. I don't have anything against aptitude tests or grades in general. They can help us to see where we currently have our strengths or interests or whether we are suitable for a certain job, if we don't find out by nature what we are particularly good at and what we feel called to do. But in my opinion, it is wrong to play off grades or skills against each other or to call the result of a single test intelligence. Why, for example, should the mathematics grade be more important than the work grade? A view which I suspect is widespread. If you want to become a civil engineer, it is certainly an advantage if you like to juggle with numbers. But if you prefer to do something manual, then you better not hit your finger with every hammer blow. Otherwise, you will probably not find much pleasure in your task. However, we need civil engineers who ensure that the house construction is built on solid foundations and craftsmen who can turn the theory into reality. In my opinion, it makes no sense to weigh up what is more important or more intelligent. I, for example, had no trouble in gym class, but when I was supposed to sing, it was just barely enough for the shower, according to my taste in music. But what would our world be without music? An infinitely more desolate place, don't you think? I believe we will never be able to express the value of music in any number, and we should stop expressing the value of a human being in any number. We are happy that we have music and that we have people who support and complement us with their individual abilities. Again and again, it is pointed out that IQ is the best factor to predicting school success and often also social advancement and social prestige. Often in this context, one even speaks of success. It may well be that a professor needs different qualities or strengths than a farmer, but why do I think most people attribute a higher social status to a professor than to a farmer? After all, the professor would starve to death if he or she didn't have the farmer, but the farmer could survive without problems. Of course, a farmer would not deny his right to exist to a professor, because he might make important discoveries that will advance farming methods or the like, but professor is certainly not more important. I think we should let them both live because we can use both. I think that the common notion of intelligence and the supposed social status are very closely related, and I think we should change something about it, because I don't think that the status quo makes sense. The question of who is the most intelligent person is just as inappropriate as the question of who is the best sportsman in the world. It is simply impossible to measure this in any meaningful way. Depending on the sport we are testing in, someone else will be swinging on top. In addition, we could invent new sports every day, just as we can never fully write down human abilities, which are always linked to cognitive performance. Imagine, for example, if we agreed that we would select the best athlete in the world by having all athletes sumo wrestling. I could imagine that we would have to turn back a few pages in the ranking until, for example, the name Roger Federer would appear. So, does such a procedure make sense for you? Probably not. And if it doesn't even make sense in sports, Why should it be any different with a term as important to our self-esteem as intelligence? In my opinion, this term is too central for our social life and the self-esteem of every human being than that we can only use it with a certain range of cognitive faculties, which I suspect many of us do. Today, grades are only used as a guide, and I currently have a completely different definition of intelligence than what an IQ test could ever measure. In my opinion, true intelligence is found in actions that improve one's own well-being, the well-being of all fellow humans, and the well-being of all sentient beings. Achieving this form of intelligence is probably not too easy. Or in every single action, I have to test myself again and again against this guideline. Of course, I will only be able to weigh this question with my limited resources in any situation, but I think that if we all had this goal, it would be worth a start, or rather a try. Of course, I have to ask myself what good means. This question about good or bad is often not easy to answer from my point of view, and I think that every person has to find an answer for himself anew in every situation. Nor do I believe that we will ever be able to resolve this issue conclusively. This definition is never complete, but must be found again and again in the hope of doing more good than bad to oneself, one's fellow man, and nature. I personally like the word self-esteem in the area of oneself. In the area of fellow humans, I find the golden rule very useful. And if you are not sure whether your counterpart really wants to be treated as you would like to be treated yourself, then you can simply ask. And in the area of environment, I like the word sustainability. Whether you prefer juggling numbers, writing lyrics, caring for people, building roads, driving vehicles, singing songs, teaching students, managing money, being at the forefront of government businesses, developing new apps, running the household, preparing food, maybe even planting it yourself or doing something else and therefore being destined for it, is very individual and should receive the same social recognition. And that is exactly why we humans are so strong as a community, because each of us is unique and we can use everyone who does something for the community. I am convinced that we cannot call some abilities intelligence and leave others out. Such a view will always lead to losses. But I would like each of us to be a winner, and for each intelligent action of each of us as a community to make us even stronger. In my opinion, the definition presented here is more likely to achieve this goal. A different definition will probably lead to more intelligent or less intelligent people, depending on which abilities are chosen to represent intelligence, which in my opinion is subjective. It's like we all measure athletes only in sumo wrestling. Some intelligence tests may figuratively calculate the average of sumo wrestling, soccer, and javelin throwing. But do you think such a test will give a meaningful answer to the question of who is the best athlete? I think not. The only answer such a test provides is who is the best in these three sports on average, but the best athlete is not. Just as the person with the highest average in IQ, intelligence quotient, EQ, emotional intelligence quotient, SQ, social intelligence quotient, CQ, creative intelligence quotient, and so on, is not the most intelligent person. We can have championships in any discipline, but I don't think that has anything to do with true intelligence. I know I wouldn't have a chance to survive on my own. Every day I need the help of countless people without whose help I would be completely lost. Our world has become so complex that I don't even know who has just helped me. For example, I have no idea how my computer here works, who designed it and who then assembled it. But if no one had done that for me, I couldn't write this text on computer now and you would probably never read it. I wouldn't have anything to eat either if someone hadn't planted food for me. Or my rubbish bags would be piled up in front of my apartment entrance if someone hadn't collected them for me. We need everyone who does something for the community. In my eyes, every person is worth exactly the same and unique at the same time. Each of us has strengths and weaknesses, and we can use every strength for the community and respect every weakness as long as it does not lead to the disadvantage of another person or nature. So if I compare the common definition of intelligence and the one proposed here, I ask myself what the practical consequences might be in reality of these theories. I would come up with something like this. The common definition of intelligence, in my opinion, leads to the fact that there are more intelligent and less intelligent people depending on how well certain cognitive abilities perform in a test that assumes that certain cognitive abilities are intelligence. However, this test results is limited to the individual person and has no positive effects on the community. Rather, it leads to a multi-class society, along the lines, too bad if you are stupid. My definition of intelligence would lead to a situation where a person would be called intelligent if he respects himself and his own needs, if she treats every fellow humans, and not only of their country or her religion, in the same way as she would like to be treated, and if necessary, also asks if it is okay how she treats her counterpart, and if she then also makes sure that our children will find all of our homes, the earth, as wonderful as we are allowed to find them even today. Now imagine two societies which, according to their respective definition of intelligence, consists exclusively of intelligent persons. With the first society, I would imagine that we would have a society which, according to our school system, would consist of professional groups requiring an academic degree. This would have died out after a few months because they had no time, probably no desire, and maybe not the skills to grow food, sew clothes, build a house, and much more. If, according to my definition of intelligence, we had a society of only intelligent people, then we would have a society in which everyone takes care of himself, his fellow humans, and nature, and uses his individual and unique strengths for this purpose, without being branded by his fellow humans in important and unimportant things. I think we can use all professions that want to make a difference for the community, even those with a degree, but just as we can use all other professions. In my opinion, everyone should be able to contribute to the community without being stigmatized by society in unimportant or more important ways, which I believe is the case at present. We are glad that there are people with the most diverse interests and cognitive strengths. We can use outstanding mathematicians just as we can use outstanding soccer players, housemen, nurses, psychiatrists, entrepreneurs, salespeople, bakers, foresters, hairdressers, chauffeurs, police officers, doctors, and so on. And each of these professions that make our lives easier and sweeter should, in my opinion, have the chance to be intelligent without being forced to believe this limited viewpoint by people who have the power to invent intelligence tests, and then to live in the belief that one is not intelligent oneself because one did not do well in math, physics and chemistry at school, or was not allowed to skip a class, or has no DR in front of one's name, or did not recognize a fixed pattern in a presented series of numbers, and so on. Why should it be important that everyone can recognize any pattern in a series of numbers? Isn't it enough if person 1 recognizes something in it, person 2 on the other hand feels, if their counterpart is not doing so well at the moment and he could use some support, or if person 3 recognizes that it is not sensible to throw the garbage into the forest? Why should it make sense that person 1 is allowed to call himself intelligent, whereas person 2 is simply called an empathic person and person 3 a nature conservationist? Does it really make sense to lease the concept of intelligence for number series? I don't think so. Intelligence should benefit us all. I will try to shape my future actions as best as I can according to this definition of intelligence, and I would be happy if you would try the same. It would probably benefit not only you, but also me, the human community and the entire planet. In this spirit, let us try to act intelligently.